Hi everyone, I'm Nita Gupta. I'm part of the network application team from Ericsson. And here I'm talking about how we are making 5G code real. So that is a shift from having the existing 4G to the 5G core. As we know, most of the industries now are moving more towards digital transformation, and everyone needs to make a move accordingly. Having said that, the existing traditional networks are having revenues, but they are quite slow. So to generate more revenue streams, have more business potential, we need to move to have this digital transformation era. So that is where we talk about seizing the 5G opportunity right now. If we move on to the use cases, what 5G brings, we can categorize them into three areas. One is the massive MTC, one is the critical MTC, and one is the enhanced mobile broadband. When we talk of massive MTC, it is more about having use cases where you need average latency, but you need extended battery power life, and you need massive volumes of devices. When we talk of enhanced mobile broadband, that is something which we have now, but you have cases like beamforming, etc., which we could use for, say, places where you need extended data usage in venues, and similar cases where you have AR, VR support as well. Then we move on to critical MTC, which is where we need a very low latency, you need high availability of devices, and also you need high reliability. That is where critical MTC comes into picture. Some of the use cases as we can discuss is, say, a remote surgery, or you could have autonomous devices and so on. So that is how we basically categorize the three use cases for 5G. What we can derive from this is basically the three areas what 5G core brings. One is a highly efficient systems and operation, that is bringing in automation and so on for efficient operations to take place. Then we bring into flexibility and speed, which comes from use cases from network slicing. So network slicing, of course, will bring more agility into the network. And then we also have the third benefit from 5G core, which is bringing in new technologies, say a distributed cloud. So again, to touch upon that, this is a very important factor where you can have low latency by having the core built into the edge itself. So that brings in, and that's very critical for use cases where you have, say, a robotic surgery and so on. Having said that, that is where Ericsson brings in its partnership, where we already have MOU signed with about 39 partners. We have it with 45 universities, and a lot of POCs and trials have been conducted. So that is what we want to say, 5G core is real and you should get there. Thank you.